At some point in the dragon's history, the Deal family established a small outpost nearby, hence the road's alternative name, Deal's Gap. The road was officially designated in the late 1920s and was likely tarred around the same time. Designated US 129, the road is bordered by the Great Smoky Mountains and the Cherokee National Forest with no intersecting roads or driveways to hamper your travel. It is considered the destination for thousands of motorcycle and sports car fans throughout the spring, summer, and fall. It's best to be cautious as the turns are tight, but the tail of the dragon is guaranteed to be the ride of your life. Okay, let's get this Corvette on camera. Brace yourself for a big, big ride. 318 curves, switchbacks, and turns on 11 miles of blacktop. Lane wants me to record some footage of him burning up the curves. These photo guys are set up to take your photo as you pass. Then you can go to the website and buy the digital pictures ready for downloading. You just need the date and time you pass them. I know he's not liking going so slow. I told him to keep me in sight so I could record him. He's letting me get ahead so I can find a spot to pull off and catch him from the front. I can hear him in the distance. I don't think I can keep up with him now. He knows that we probably have enough recorded. He's ready to have fun and let the horses run. A lot of motorcycle riders out this morning. this is a fun road to ride on. Unfortunately, there has been a lot of wrecks and fatalities throughout the years. It took years, numerous accidents, close calls, and a motorcyclist death to finally get the late great state of Tennessee to ban trucks on this stretch of highway. Dragon lover Dwight Ike Woodward was killed by a semi-truck at mile marker 6 in 2011. His needless death was not in vain, as it resulted in the state of Tennessee finally banning these vehicles from the famed roadway. Fall is a popular time for motorcycle enthusiasts to ride because of the moderate temperatures and comfortable conditions. I finally caught up with the Corvette. I think I will name it the White Streak of the Dragon, because that is all I could see as he speeds through the curves. Harry and Jim went ahead of us on their Can-Am Spiders, while Lane and I played cat and mouse and did some recording with the GoPro on the Dragon.
I was wondering, he showed up and I was like,
all I saw was a white streak going through the woods.
You what? The white streak?
Yeah.
He said you put the gas to it and he said that was it. That's all he saw, man.
I just saw a white streak.
Kick in, go like that. And I tried to keep up with him and he was zipping around those curves.
There you go.
Especially those ones you go downhill like that, man. I would go down there and my traction control was going.
See, the master teacher taught the students, now the students teaching the teacher.
Yeah, that's true.
On how to ride properly, ride a Can-Am.
Harry is explaining that he had a hard time keeping up with Jim in the curves.
He was a lot more confident this year than he was 2 years ago.
I sounded like you did.
Yeah, there's a couple times when I was in second gear.
Lane is explaining that he had the vet under control, but did let it run some. What a great ride on the Dragon. Now we are going to ride the Foothills Parkway. Thank you so much for watching.